And here is the Writer's Almanac for Friday, the 16th of October, 2020. It's the birthday of the playwright Eugene O'Neill, born in a hotel room on Broadway, New York City, 1888. His father, famous actor, always on the road. Eugene O'Neill was 24 years old when he started to read classic playwrights and decided to do that. Ibsen, Strindberg impressed him. Fell in with a group of theater people in Provincetown, Massachusetts, called the Provincetown Players, which produced O'Neill's plays on a regular basis. 1920, his play Beyond the Horizon became a popular success on Broadway, followed by Anna Christie, Strange Interlude, and Long Day's Journey into Night. After Shakespeare and George Bernard Shaw, Eugene O'Neill, the most widely presented and translated dramatist in the English-speaking world. His were the first real tragedies of the American stage, the first to dispense with formal language in favor of slang. Eugene O'Neill, who said, "Life is for each man a solitary cell whose walls are mirrors." It's the birthday of the playwright who said the only way to get rid of a temptation is to yield to it, Oscar Wilde, born in Dublin, 1854, author of the plays Lady Windermere's Fan, A Woman of No Importance, and The Importance of Being Earnest. Oscar Wilde, who went off to England after college, became part of the High Society of London and a movement in art and literature called aestheticism, art for art's sake. Came to the United States on a lecture tour, stopped everywhere from Des Moines to Denver, from St. Paul to Houston, visited Walt Whitman in Pennsylvania, lectured to rich people, also to coal miners and cowboys. Went back to London and wrote his first and only novel, The Picture of Dorian Gray, about a beautiful young man who remains young while a portrait of him grows older and older. And it's the birthday of the lexicographer and educational reformer Noah Webster, born Hartford, 1758. Went to Yale, taught school for a while, went to law school, passed the bar, and then turned to writing. He was horrified that American schoolchildren were using British spellers and grammars, so he set out to write his own. It was called The Blue-Backed Speller, in which British spellings were changed to American, the R-E to E-R, in words like center. 1807, he began compiling an American Dictionary of the English Language. It took him 28 years to complete. And to do it, he learned 28 languages, including Sanskrit, Persian, and Gothic. Noah Webster, also responsible for establishing copyright laws, and he was a co-founder of Amherst College. Here's a poem for today by Joyce Sutphen, entitled Silo Solo. My father climbs into the silo. He has come, rung by rung, up the wooden trail that scales that tall belly of cement. It's winter, 20 below zero. He can hear the wind overhead. The silage beneath his boots is so frozen it has no smell. My father takes up a pickaxe and chops away a layer of silage. He works neatly counterclockwise under a yellow light, then lifts the chunks with a pitchfork and throws them down the chute. They break as they fall and rattle far below. His breath comes out in clouds. His fingers begin to ache, but he skims off another layer where the frost is forming and begins to sing, "You are my sunshine. My only sunshine." A poem, Silo Solo, Joyce Sutphen, from her collection First Words, published by Red Dragonfly Press and used by permission here on the Writer's Almanac, funded by donations from listeners like you. Be well, do good work, and keep in touch.